So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. In today's class, we'll be discussing the current affairs, the PIB news from 31st and 30th January 2023. All right. So without any delay, let's begin with very first question, which says Ministry of Ports, Shipping and Waterways has invited expression of interest for development of international container transshipment port at Galatia Bay. So you have to identify incorrect statement about this port, right? So new international container transshipment port will be constructed at Galatia Bay, right? And it is in Great Nicobar Island. So you have to identify incorrect statement about this port. So let's talk about it. So the news is this only, that the expression of interest has been invited, right? Expression of interest ka matlab hota hai ki bids wagaira ya applications wagaira, right? So basically applications have been invited for development of international container transshipment port at Galatia Bay, which is located in Great Nicobar Islands of Andaman and Nicobar, right? This port's handling capacity will be 16 million containers per year when it will be fully constructed, and the targeted investment is 41,000 crores, right? It will be constructed, it will be built at an investment of 41,000 crore, which is approximately US dollar 5 billions, and investment jo hogi wo government aur public private partnership dono se aayegi, right? The investment will be from government and the public private partnership, or you can say government and private players, theek hai. Now talking more about this port, so the nodal ministry of course is Ministry of Ports, Shipping and Waterways, and remember the implementing agency, right? Overall guidelines, overall execution of this project will be done by Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Port of Kolkata, right? The mode of development, I already told you, it will be developed in the public-private partnership mode, where the PPP concessionaire, the public-private partnership concessionaire, will have the flexibility to develop storage area, container handling equipment and other infrastructure. And this PPP concessionaire will be awarded for a long-term period of 30 to 50 years. 30 saal se 50 saal tak ke liye unko diya jayega, aur uske baad इस पीरियड में दे विल रिकवर देयर प्रॉफिट्स एंड दे विल एग्जिट फ्रॉम दिस पोर्ट, राइट? उसके बाद तो पूरा गवर्नमेंट ओन हो जाएगा. ड्यूरेशन की बात करें, सो दिस फैसिलिटी विल बी डेवलप्ड इन फोर फेजेस. इन द फर्स्ट फेज, इट इज टारगेटेड दैट द कैपेसिटी ऑफ 4 मिलियन कंटेनर्स विल बी डेवलप विद अ टोटल कॉस्ट ऑफ 18,000 करोड़ इन द फर्स्ट फेज. अभी फर्स्ट फेज की बात इन्होंने करी है, बट ओवरऑल इट विल बी डेवलप्ड विद इन फोर फेजेस. In the first phase, total 18,000 crore will be invested, right, till the year 2028 with a total container capacity of 4 million. Okay, but the total capacity will be how much? 16 million containers in a year when it will be completed. All right. So that is all about this new port, and now let's identify the incorrect statement. So it will be located in Kavarati near Lakshadweep Island. No, Galatia Bay is in Great Nicobar Island. So this statement is incorrect. It will have handling capacity of 16 million containers per year. This is absolutely correct. It is envisaged to be developed in four phases with investment of rupees 41,000 crores. Bilkul sahi baat hai. It will be developed through public-private partnership via landlord mode. Ye bhi sahi hai. And Jawaharlal Nehru Port Trust Mumbai will be the nodal agency for this. No, the nodal agency is which port? Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Port of Kolkata. So this is also incorrect. So therefore, the correct answer will be option B, 1 and 5, because we have to identify the incorrect statement. Moving ahead to question number 2. This is something which is very interesting and very important. National Logistic Portal Marine has been launched recently to serve as a one-stop marketplace where all the logistic stakeholders will have all the information regarding the logistic services. The question is, this portal has been envisaged by which ministry or ministries? Kaun si ministry ya fir ministries isko leke aa rahi hai? Kaun isko develop kar rahi hai? Kisne launch kiya hai? Theek hai? So let's talk about this. So National Logistic Portal Marine has been launched, and it will serve as a one-stop marketplace where all the information regarding logistic will be provided to the stakeholders. And it will be, you know, it will make easier, speedier and competitive services, and thereby promoting the trade and growth, right? Jab sare processing, sare information mil jayegi aasani se, to of course it will enhance the trade and the growth of the logistics sector. Now talking about the objectives in a broad manner. So first of all, it will connect all the stakeholders of the logistics at a common platform using information technology, number one. And with this, it will improve the efficiency and transparency by reducing cost and time delays. Costing kam ho jayegi, time delays jo hote the, wo kam ho jayega. And it will achieve easier, faster and more competitive offerings of services, right? It is envisaged by Ministry of Ports, Shipping and Waterways and the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Ministry of Ports, Shipping and Waterways. So there are two ministries. Ministry of Ports, Shipping and Waterways and Ministry of Commerce and Industry. All right. It will be a single window for all trade processes of the logistics sector spread across the country. Thereby, it will reduce the cost and it will also reduce the time delays. Right. And it will cover all modes of transport like waterways, roadways and airways, along with an e-marketplace to provide a seamless end-to-end logistics service coverage. So basically, all modes of transport will be covered through this national logistic portal. And the activities have been categorized into four verticals. The activities of this portal have been categorized into four portals: career, cargo, banking and finance, regulatory body and participating government agencies. Right? So do remember these four areas: career, cargo, banking and finance, regulatory and participating government agencies. So that is all about this portal. And which two ministries are these? Ministry of Ports, Shipping and Waterways and Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Therefore, the correct answer, guys, will be option D, A and B. Moving ahead to question number 3. Recently, a list of 120 startups and innovators for the XR startup program was announced. So you have to identify correct statement or statements about the XR startup program. So the news is this only, that a new list of 120 startups and innovators has been released under XR startup program, and these 120 startups and innovators will be provided support in the under the XR startup program. Now these startups and innovators are those which are working in the extended reality ecosystem. Here in the XR startup program, XR means extended reality only. So basically, it will discover, nurture and accelerate the extended reality technology startups across the country. Okay? Now, and remember, this list has been released for the XR startup program by Mighty Startup Hub and Meta. Mighty Startup Hub and Meta. Meta, of course, we all know is the parent company of Facebook. Now remember, out of all these startups which have been selected to provide support, 30% are from tier 2 and tier 3 cities across the nation, and 40% of these innovators and startups in the grand challenge are from tier 2 and tier 3 cities. So basically, there are two components of XR startup program. One is accelerator program and one is grand challenge. So under accelerator program, 30% are from tier 2 and 3 cities across the nation, and 40% of the selected innovators and startup in the grand challenge are from tier 2 and 3 cities, right? And more than 20% are those startups and innovators which have women co-founders or CEOs, right? Now talking about XR startup program, so of course the objective is to boost the extended reality ecosystem in the country. It was launched last year in the month of September by Ministry of Electronics and IT through its initiative Mighty Start Hub, right? Mighty Startup ke through isko launch kiya gaya tha. And there are two components here, as I told you. One is accelerator program, one is grand challenge. Under accelerator program, XR startup program provides support to 40 early stage startups working in the XR technology with a grant of rupees 20 lakh each. Har startup ko 20 lakh rupay ka grant milta hai. And in the grand challenge, basically the challenges are invited for these XR startups in the area of education, learning skills, healthcare, entertainment, agri-tech, climate action, climate change, wagera wagera. All right. Now implementation in all the zones, in all the four zones, there are different implementing agencies. In the north zone, it is Foundation for Innovation and Technology at IIT Delhi. In south zone, it is Center for Innovation and Entrepreneurship at IIIT Hyderabad. In East Zone, it is Atal Incubation Center of Sikkim Manipal University Technology Business Incubation Foundation. And in the West Zone, it is Gujarat University Startup and Entrepreneurship Council. So these are the four implementing agencies in the four respective zones, North, South, East and West. All right. So I hope this is clear. And now let's come back to the question. We have to identify the correct statement. The program was launched in 2021. No. It is being implemented by Foundation for Innovation and Technology Transfer at IIT Delhi in the North Zone. Correct. This program is a collaboration of Mighty Startup Hub and Meta. Yes, ye bilkul sahi baat hai. So 2 and 3, option B will be the correct answer. Only 2 and 3 will be the correct answer because we have to identify correct statement. Now you should focus on the word. Whether you have to identify the correct statement or the incorrect statement. Theek hai? Now let's talk about question number 4. The first International Financial Architecture Working Group meeting of G20 under India's G20 presidency will take place in Chandigarh. Which of the following will be moderating the discussions of this meeting? Kaun kaun si agencies in mein se in is discussion ko moderate karenge? So moderate karne wali hongi Ministry of Finance and Reserve Bank of India. Right? The discussions will be jointly moderated by Ministry of Finance and Reserve Bank of India. And remember, this International Financial Architecture Working Group meeting will be co-chaired by the co-chairs of this International Financial Architecture Working Group, which are France and South Korea. Okay? And finally, one more event will also take place on the sidelines of this meeting, which is G20 event titled Central Bank Digital Currencies, Opportunities and Challenges, where India will showcase India will showcase its central bank digital currency and what are the opportunities and what are the challenges in front of RBI in effective implementation of CBDC. All right. So what will be the correct answer then? Ministry of Finance and RBI, option D. Option D will be the correct answer. Question number 5 pe aa jaate hain isi baat pe. Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports, headed by Anurag Thakur, recently launched a special mobile app for the upcoming Khelo India Youth Games, the 5th edition, which will take place in Madhya Pradesh. Right? Which state will host this edition? So I already told you the correct answer would be Madhya Pradesh. And now talking about this app. So this app, what will this app do? So basically every type of information will be provided to the athletes, to the coach, everyone. So to ensure that participating athletes, coaches, support staff, parent of athletes and officials participating have access to all information about the Khelo India Youth Games. Har tarike ki information, registration ki, location ki, games ki, every type of information will be provided to them. Now this is the first time that a dedicated app has been launched for any edition of Khelo India Youth Games. So this is also very interesting. It has a dedicated athlete login and it will provide support to the athlete right from the time of his or her registration into the game throughout the games. ठीक है, पूरे time तक उसको support मिलेगा athlete को. Alright. So app में ज़्यादा कुछ पढ़ने की ज़रूरत है नहीं. So this the correct answer is, one second. कहाँ गया भाई? Khelo India app. Okay. So this edition will take place in Madhya Pradesh. Option C is the correct answer. Alright guys, now let's talk about the questions which do not need much explanations. These are very direct. But before that, if you want to have the PDF of this session, you can join this Telegram channel. The link is in description. And if you want to ask anything related to examination, you can follow me here. Let's talk about question number 6. Where was the National Brainstorming Session on Empowering Young Scientists of India held to assimilate ideas for enhancing the avenues of empowering young scientists? Remember, Empowering Young Scientists is the program of Office of Principal Scientific Advisor to the Government of India. Now, can you tell me who is the Principal Scientific Advisor to the Government of India? Write down in the comment section. So this National Brainstorming Session on Empowering Young Scientists took place in IIT BHU, which is located in Varanasi. Option B is the correct answer. Question number 7 pe aa jaate hain. Which ministry has formed a pastoral cell? This is very important. To prioritize enabling policies for the pastoral community. So a pastoral cell has been created by the Ministry of Panchayati Raj, whereby it is prioritizing or it is enabling the policies for pastoral communities and encouraging women participation in future interactions and motivating youth. So basically, for the welfare of pastoral community, this pastoral cell has been formed by the Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairy, not Panchayati Raj, Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairy, right? Option B is the correct answer. Question number 8. Where has Young Startup Conclave been organized by CSIR under Ministry of Science and Technology? So very direct question. I don't think that there is the need of any explanation here. And in these conclaves, nothing happens. मतलब ऐसा नहीं है, कुछ नहीं होता, बस discussions होती हैं. So those discussions are not important for the examination. All right? वो आपको पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं है. Just don't waste your time in learning all those discussion points कि क्या-क्या discussions हुए हैं. That is not important. ठीक है? So it has been organized in Kathua in Jammu. Option C is the correct answer. Question number 9. R&D Institute Samir, which has recently signed an MOU with Siemens Healthineers, and this MOU has been signed for development of new, improved and innovative technologies for advancing healthcare and diagnostic access in India. So Samir is India's premier R&D institute under which ministry? कौन सी मिनिस्ट्री के अंडर ये काम करता है? एंड रिमेंबर, समीर ऑफ कोर्स हैज अ फुल फॉर्म व्हिच इज सोसाइटी फॉर अप्लाइड माइक्रोवेव इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंजीनियरिंग एंड रिसर्च. ठीक है, नाउ रिमेंबर, समीर इज एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन अंडर माइटी मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड आईटी हेडेड बाय अश्विनी वैष्णव. ऑप्शन सी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 10. व्हिच मिनिस्ट्री इज ऑर्गेनाइजिंग अ वन डे डेलिबरेशन मीट मंथन चार्टिंग न्यू पाथ्स in New Delhi to brainstorm and develop a roadmap for improving its current e-governance applications, primarily e-Gram Swaraj. So whenever I would see e-Gram Swaraj, I will mark the answer as Ministry of Panchayati Raj without any doubt. Option B is the correct answer. Question number 11. India and Egypt recently has signed an MOU for cultural cooperation. So what is the duration of this MOU? So India and Egypt both have signed an MOU whereby both the countries will cooperate each other in the area of culture, right? So this MOU has been signed for a period of 10 years. Option E is the correct answer. 10 सालों के लिए ये MOU sign किया गया है without any doubt. Once again, guys, I think there is some issue with the voice. Hello. Yes. All right. So India and Egypt recently have signed an MOU for cultural cooperation. So duration of this MOU is 5 years. Option D is the correct. I told you 10 years. Not that. That is not 10 years. That 5 years. I'm sorry for that. 5 years. 5 saal ke MOU sign hua hai. Question number 12. Which ministry is organizing Vitatsa program to showcase the rich culture, arts and crafts of Kashmir? Theek hai? This is important. As a symbol of the spirit of Ek Bharat, Shreshth Bharat to other states. ठीक है? Vitatsa program is being organized by Ministry of Culture. Option A is the correct answer. And remember, in the previous question, I am repeating it. The duration of this MOU is 5 years and not 10 years. I mistakenly marked the answer as 10 years, but it is 5 years. ठीक है? Question number 13, which is the last question for today. With which country India has signed an MOU on cooperation for reintroduction of a new batch of 12 cheetahs in the month of February 2023? Is mahine 12 cheetah aur aayenge, and this MOU has been signed with South Africa. Option A is the correct answer. So iske baad 20 cheetah ho jayenge hamare desh mein, 8 pehle aaye the. All right, so that's it for today's class. I hope all the questions and their explanations are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. And I hope आप सबने बजट और इकोनॉमिक सर्वे का सेशन देख लिया होगा. नहीं देखा है तो प्लीज गो वॉच दोज सेशंस. दोज आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर एनी गवर्नमेंट एग्जाम्स यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर. ऑलराइट, सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.